So, Vlad, we're hearing from the Commerce Department that it is actually going to take action on this. Bring us up to date on what could happen, how this could escalate.
Well, that's still kind of to be determined. The major things that we know, because we went and we tore down the device and we figured out the chips on the inside, is, like you mentioned, SMIC is the manufacturer of the main applications processor. But then the latest findings from Tech Insights with their teardown also show that the majority of the other components for this device are also made in China by kind of unheralded companies. These are not major traded international chip makers. These are smaller players within China's own ecosystem. And it speaks to the fact that China is doing what it has said that it wants to do, which is build self-sufficiency in the semiconductor sphere.
Vlad, we spoke to Dan Hutchison from Tech Insights just a little bit earlier, and it was actually interesting. He was pretty, I guess, almost sanguine about the developments. He wasn't terribly surprised, and he doesn't think that that development gap in terms of, you know, where they could go from here is going to be closed that easily. What does it kind of tell you about the progress that China has been able to make despite these sanctions?
Yes, and I think that is a key issue that we need to stress here. China has made a major leap, but that is only to not even catch up, to come a little bit closer. The gap between international chip making, global chip making, where you have the vast international supply chain that spans American, Japanese, German, Taiwanese, Korean companies, and just doing it domestically, whether within China or any other country, is massive. So, sure, China has made a big leap. I mean, you can validly say the US could never make a device as fully featured with just made in USA technology. But still, there is years, generations of technology between where China is today and where the global supply chain is. And it's worth also saying what China has achieved in terms of 7-nanometer technology might just be hitting the ceiling of what's achievable, again, without international suppliers such as ASML from the Netherlands.